So we have gone through how to add services, how to look through the content, and now we're going to go to the Measure tab and the Reports Hub. So you can click on Measure, and the purpose of this is to see how you are performing on social media. So if you have your Facebook page connected, your Twitter, your Instagram, LinkedIn, etc., go ahead and click on one of those. We're just going to go with Facebook page for now. So click on Facebook page, and then it's going to pull up your Facebook page, and you're going to be able to see how many impressions over the last 28 days. But if you want to do, you know, filter the dates from a week or however you want to do it, this month, last week, this week, you can go ahead and do that. And then click on filter, and it's going to redo your report. So it'll tell you how many impressions. So impressions means the total number of impressions seen of any content associated with your page. You're going to see the reach, and that's the number of people who have seen any content associated with your page for the 7 days. Post engagements, that means how many people have liked or commented on your social media. And then once you scroll down, you're going to go to audience growth. And this is unlikes right here. So you're going to be able to see how many people have liked. So whenever somebody likes your page, it's going to go up. Whenever somebody unlikes your page, it's going to go down. This is actually a Facebook that I don't use anymore. So that's why it's kind of iffy here. But I just wanted to show you this as an example. So now you can scroll down. And you can see all the different kinds of analytics on here. So you can see your likes by day, your posts by day, your photos by day, top performing posts. It says no data available yet for your top performing posts. Just wait about 24 hours and you will be able to see that. So whenever you go to Instagram, you can click on that. Now I was going to say select your Instagram account. This one I have not used in so long. So if it might not have the best analytics there either. So we're just going to go ahead and click on that just to show you as an example. Click on generate report. And then it's going to show you how many people, no data available just yet. So that might take up to from 12 to 24 hours to upgrade all this. So this is a really good way to see how you're performing on your social media accounts, how you're doing on LinkedIn, how you're doing on Twitter, how many followers you're gaining, how many people are commenting, how many people are liking, what posts are working, what posts aren't working. You can take the posts that are working and try to focus and post more of that. So that's a really great way. And then you can also do a report builder where you can build your own report. So let's just do test here, test. Default period, I guess it doesn't matter. Last 30 days. Let's do last 14 days. Select layout, one column, create report. So we're just going to create a report of your channel. So you can click on that and you can add what you want to add to your report. So we can do audience engagement, audience growth. Let's see, number of followers you got. Media, publishing, close. So now you're creating your own little report that you can go to all the time and go back and look at it. So if you're only interested in how many followers you're getting, if you're only interested in how many people are liking your posts, you can actually make that as an option and you can go to Measure and Reports Hub and My Reports in order to see that. See, whenever you go to My Reports, it's going to say test, and that's what you're going to see is your followers and whatever data that you wanted to put there. So that's just a quick overview of Measure and to look at your analytics. If you have any questions about this, please feel free to email me, molly@theagentnest.com, and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye!